good day everybody, and welcome back to the channel. So this reading is for Sagittarius. Make sure that you hit all when you tap that notification bell, because if you don't hit all, YouTube ain't gonna let you know when I'm uploading, okay? So I appreciate you guys for tuning in. If you're new to this channel, welcome. Please make sure you hit like, comment, and subscribe. Tap that notification bell. Also, if you're interested in custom crystal jewelry, guess what? I got this from Level Up Arts. You can follow them on Instagram. The information is in the description below. If you're interested in, this is a time of relaxation, a time of rest. If you're interested in receiving any cosmetic, what is it called? Metaphysical type of chakra alignment type of products, look at Shock Therapy. The link is in the description below. Use my promo code and you will receive a discount. Every time I use Shock Therapy, you know, it gets me all the way right, gets me all the way aligned. This is one of the Ajna Awakening candles right here. All right, so Spirit, what do we got for Sagittarius, okay? Let's see what do we have for Sagittarius. All right. Ooh. So first thing Source is wanting you to do, Sag, is they want you to connect with some emotions. All right. So in order to connect with these emotions, you got to first figure out what these emotions are and when are they showing up? You know, really, when are they showing up? And so once they show up, you have to begin to explore those emotions so that you can understand, like, hey, you know, I wonder what's going on, you know, so you can track it down, figure out when this emotion surfaced for you, understanding, you know, what triggered that emotion. Because sometimes when certain emotions, you know, come about, that means that that may still be a trigger for you. So just really connecting to whatever these emotions are. Like, it's probably like an imbalance of emotions right now, especially given all of the different types of energies that we're being exposed to. So just really figuring out what those emotions are, maybe journaling them and writing them down so you can explore them in the future. Yeah. And so with this, you know, this process of healing, this journey that you're on, Source is wanting you to be devoted and committed to this process. All right. They're wanting you to really sit down. See, he got a little, he writing some things down. So that shows that devotion and that commitment. That shows that you really want to challenge these emotions that you're feeling, and you really want to get down to the bottom of why these things keep coming up for you. All right. Source is also saying that, listen, in order for you to really connect with these emotions, it's going to have to be a lot of, it's the season of the death, okay? It's time for you to cut some ties with some folks. It's time for you to release some things, you know, and this has been a season of release. And, you know, once you begin to release and allowing that old to die out, guess what's going to happen? You'll start noticing that new things are going to begin to come in. And what usually happens in autumn, because this is the autumn card. So when in autumn, you notice that all the things that sprouted in the spring begin to die out, you know, and then they begin to make room for the new that's going to come into your life. So it's time to release some things, release all the things that are no longer serving you, release people that are no longer serving you. It's time to let all of that stuff go. All right. Source is also saying that, you know, they want you to kind of be graceful. You know, be easy with yourself. You don't have to be so assertive with anything that you're doing right now. This is a time of patience. This is a time of grace. This is a time of ease. So just really be patient with yourself and just be graceful in your actions. You don't have to do anything so fast. So like this, I know you probably want to get rid of like certain emotions or certain feelings that you're having like right away, but Source is like, nah, this ain't one of them processes that it's gonna be like, all right, I'm healed. You know, this is gonna be one of them processes. It's gonna take some time. It's gonna take some fine tuning in order to get it right. All right. Source is also saying that, listen, you're constantly worried about where you're headed, and you're gonna get there. All right. You're gonna have the life that you desire. But in order to have the life that you desire, there are things that are going to have to take place. And as these things take place, you'll begin to notice that once you really connect with these emotions, you start holding in and being really devoted to this journey right here, guess what's going to happen? You'll start seeing yourself align the way that you're supposed to align, and then you're going to have the life of your dreams. And trust in the unknown. You know, have faith. You got to have faith in this process. Have faith that everything that you're doing is going to work out. And guess what? If you have faith that it's going to work out, guess what? It's going to work out. All right? You are not by yourself. You are not by yourself. You have the entire universe on your side. You have Father Sky on your side. So you are not alone in this journey. All right. You can do this. You can do this. You just have to believe that you can do it. And those emotions, those certain belief systems that pop up, that's just really a figment of your imagination. That's why Source is wanting you to connect with them so that you can really, you know, work out the kinks in that. Because it's like, as long as those emotions are there, you're going to kind of keep self-sabotaging yourself. You don't want to keep doing that because you're actually in a great position. Oh, all right. So the moon, that's that emotion again. Okay, that's that emotion again. So it's like, it's just really a serious connection with these emotions. Like, you, the moon card is here and it's like, oh yeah, you're really feeling it. But you're supposed to be coming into balance. So once you connect with those emotions, this is representation that you will come into balance. All right. It may not feel like you're going to come into balance right now, but you are definitely going to come into balance. All right. You're going to be in perfect harmony. You're going to be in perfect alignment, as represented by this moon card. Okay. So, I wouldn't be too stressed about, you know, all of the different types of energy surrounding your emotions right now. I would just do as directed and journal these things so that you can understand what you're up against. But yeah, this moon goddess, it's like, it's about to be some healing going on. All right. And this is Ixchel. And Ixchel is the soul of the moon. All right. And so it's like, this is going to be like, once you really connect, this is going to be something magical. All right. This is going to be something magical that's going to take place once you really connect to these emotions. All right. And so I'm telling you, just load up on your prayer life. Write these things down, whatever it is that you're feeling, pay attention to it, pay attention to what you're thinking in your subconscious, really pay attention to your conscious mind, do a lot of deep reflection, and the more deep reflection you do, the more that's going to be revealed to you during this time. Expression, yes, yes, and once you do this connection, you're going to really be able to express things the way that you are desiring to express them, all right? So this is the Eight of Expression. This is showing that, you know, once all of these different connections are made, you're really going to be able to live out your heart's desires. You're going to be able to express what's really in your heart. You're going to be able to connect with the things that is really in your heart, the things that you really want to do, not the things that you're doing just because somebody else said you need to be doing them. It's the things that you wanted to do. This is like, you're going to be really communicating with yourself in all honesty. Like, you're going to be really, like, when you're doing this work, you're going to be talking to yourself, and you're going to be talking to yourself with total honesty, because now you're not confused by any mixed emotions or anything like that. But yeah, you're creative, and you're going to just notice that you have a certain type of uniqueness that is going to be displayed here in the near future for the world to see. So also, the Ace of Manifestation, this is something new right here, all right? This is something new. So once you begin to do this self-expression, you're going to notice that, and you clear these emotions up, you're going to notice that you are going to be able to manifest like no other. You're going to be able to manifest the new beginning. You're going to be able to manifest the desires of your heart. And I know you're like, oh man, this sounds like the same thing you just said on the last card. Like, because they're similar. They're all intertwined. Like, they all work hand in hand. And so this eighth of manifestation, right, it is like the crown of creation. So you're bringing substance to the world. You know what I'm saying? You're bringing substance to the world. You're bringing substance to the earth. And so a lot of things are going to change. Like, you're going to be able to manifest good health. Your income is going to take off. You're going to really take advantage of a lot of opportunities that's being presented to you. And you're going to be prosperous. All right. This is a reflection that you're going to be prosperous. But again, that's what the connection of the emotion is needed for. And lastly, just centering and grounding and balancing yourself. Just balancing your energy, okay? So, and this of the emotions, like, once you really connect with these emotions, you're going to easily be able to center and balance your energies out. And you'll begin to notice, like, a lot of things are going to change once you begin to ground and center your energies out, all right? So, that's all it is, just really bringing it all in, all right? Bringing it all in. After you're doing that reflection, just bringing it all in. So, the moon card, we have 18. And the expression card is number 8. The earth card, is the ace of manifestation is just an ace. is Ace of Manifestation. And then the sensory card is number two. So if you want to write your number down, I know a lot of people enjoy looking at their numbers and, you know, looking at the cards so that they can go and do their own additional work on their own. So I'm just giving you guys your numbers. All right, Source, what else do you have for Sagittarius? Overall, though, like, y'all got it. Just take your time. Take time with yourself, all right? Okay, so guess, check this out. You got to make them steps, all right? You got to take those steps. So every journey starts with a single step. So the first step for you would be figuring out those emotions, all right? And then taking the action necessary for you to figure out, you know, why those emotions are present, all right? But every journey starts with a single step, and your number is 12. And then receiving, being able to receive the messages that Source is giving you. And that's why they want you to be devoted and committed to this journey, because they want you in the space of receiving. They want you to be able to receive whatever it is that they're telling you so that you could be on track, all right? Because, I mean, you already on track, but you can be even more on track once you just really pay attention to a lot of the things that they're saying to you. And so a lot of the stuff that they're saying is about these emotions. And it's just like, it's like you good, but like, it's just these emotions just keep coming up and they keep appearing, you know. So that means that there's something that really needs to be worked through with them emotions. So inner trust. So one of the things that's becoming present is this inner trust. It's like you're having a difficult time trusting, you know, yourself, you know, not in, and you know, and this is, you may not even trust other people, but you also have a difficult time trusting yourself. And so Source is like, look, I need you to be more trusting of yourself. I need you to be more trusting of your own intuition, more trusting of the decisions that you're making. So you're going to have to establish trust within yourself, all right? Spirit, what else do you have for Sagittarius? Okay, so yeah, you're becoming increasingly sensitive right now, and you're becoming increasingly sensitive because there's a lot going on. Okay, so you're becoming increasingly sensitive to a lot of the energies around you, and you need to acknowledge that sensitivity. You know, you need to really pay close attention to it. And again, pay attention to the things that your body is telling you. So if your body is telling you like, hey, I don't feel like engaging, then don't engage. You know, if your body is telling you like, something's not right about this situation, then guess what? Something may not be right about that situation. But, you know, really being able to understand what it is this my intuition or is this my ego? And then when you're noticing that you're empathic and you're feeling these sensitivities, knowing when to pull back. Okay, so Spirit said like you about to be doing some environmentalist stuff. Like you're gonna be working with Mother Earth, doing something in nature. All right, so you're being called to that. So you're being called to help the environment. All right. So this is also saying don't back down. So now when they're saying don't back down, they're saying that when you make decisions, don't back away from the decisions that you're making, all right? If you believe in something and you know that what you're believing in is right, continue to believe in that. Don't allow anyone to sway your beliefs. Don't allow anyone to sway your decisions, because that's going back, that's like counterintuitive. Like it's counterproductive. It's like you're trying to trust your intuition, and then someone else tell you something and now you're second guessing your own intuition. So Spirit is like, no, don't do that. Do not back down from whatever these decisions that you're making as far as it goes when you're trusting your intuition. All right, they're not saying go out there and argue or fight or nothing like that, but they're saying that when you make these decisions, you know, when you trust your intuition, don't fall back. Don't back down. All right, so Spirit, what else do you have? I'm going to look at the healing for Sagittarius. Okay, so love. All right, so this love, there's some healing surrounding love. So self-love, maybe there's some compromise on the way that you love, how you give love, how you receive love. But there is some things that are needed to be worked on when it comes to love. Maybe your home life, maybe your family life. Just really focusing in on that number 28. So right here we have 12, 27, and 2. And then this healing card is 28. We have right here having faith, 22. Really having faith in this process. Really having faith in yourself. So continue to have faith. It's like there's a lack of faith. And so you need to heal that ability. Because when you're going about things, you have to, you know, be a bit more trusting. And so this is what they was talking about. Like, hey, we need you to trust in the unknown. We need you to trust in the things that you can't see. So this is a limited amount of faith here. And so they want you to build your faith up. All right. And then just be cautious of your dreams. Three, don't self-sabotage yourself. Be mindful of how you express your dreams. You know, when you are dreaming and you have a vision, don't say, oh, I feel like it's not going to work out because. Don't self-sabotage yourself. Don't second guess yourself. Just continue to press forward when it comes to you and your dreams, all right? Spirit, what else do you have for Sagittarius? I'm getting ready to close it out, Sagittarius. If you want the extended version of this reading, though, you can always follow me on Patreon where you can get that extended version. All right, Spirit, what else? Okay, so once these things start aligning, you'll begin to notice that things will take off in an accelerated motion. They always reassuring you with this. Things are going to take off in accelerated motion, but there are things that you have to do. You can't halfway participate in your rescue here. All right, so there are things that you're going to have to do in order for you to see this acceleration. But once you do it, it's on and popping. So that's pretty much it, Sagittarius. I'm going to go ahead. We're going to go move on into the extended version of this reading. If you want the extended version of this reading, go ahead and follow us on Patreon. And I'll talk to you later.